Today I'm going to talk all about masking in Snapseed, or in Snapseed's terms, how to use tags brush. You'll also learn few tips and tricks along the way. Basically, in general terms, masking is hiding or revealing portions of an edit or filter applied. I'm going to be using this image to show some examples regarding masking. But first, I need to apply a filter to this image. We'll try the HDRscape filter with the nature preset. Gonna increase the saturation. Also the HDR filter strength. As you can see, the image doesn't look good on certain parts, especially the sky. So we'll try to selectively apply the HDR effect only on the buildings here. Now we are going to the major part of masking to do that. Tap on the stacks icon on the top right. In the options below, tap View Edits. Tap the filter we applied now and select the stacks brush. Here's the masking screen. The invert icon in the bottom left turns the filter on or off. The eye in the right is a toggle which gives a visual red mask. This helps in seeing where the effect is brushed out or not. It comes in handy when you're not sure where the masking is being applied. At the center, you can set the brush transparency values at 25 count increments. As I was planning to give the HDR effect only on the buildings, with the effect hidden, that is with the filter off, and with the brush value at 100, I'm gonna brush manually on the buildings. Again, toggling the eye icon lets you see where exactly the effect is being applied. Now you can see the full HDR effect on the buildings. Next, I'm gonna try to also give some HDR effect to the sky, but full HDR filter doesn't look too good. So with the brush transparency set at 50, brushing on the sky to give it literally 50% of the HDR effect. I will leave the water as it was before. Thing to note that in this case, I added the effect after it was hidden initially. Make sure not to toggle the invert button when applying, as it would invert the effect. You can also apply the same effect with the filter applied. So with the invert button on, that is the filter visible, and with the brush transparency set at 0, I'm gonna brush out the effect on water, won't touch the buildings here, and then with the brush value at 50, applying it in the sky. So you can basically apply the same effect with the filter hidden or applied. This is a personal choice. Now I'm gonna apply some contrast in the Tune Image menu. Then with masking, the filter hidden and the brush transparency set at 100, applying it on only the buildings. Next, I'm gonna try selectively darkening part of the sky. So using curves, dragging the top point lower, also the middle part towards right to darken the overall image. Going to the masking screen, with the effect hidden and brush transparency at 100, applying on the left part of the sky. Zooming out gives you a soft feathered mask. Wearing the brush transparency and brushing in the sky to make it more interesting. Next, I'm gonna try cloning the boat with masking. Before that, I'm gonna save the image. Next, with the double exposure tool, selecting the now saved image. As it is the same image added, it doesn't look different here. Increasing the transparency of the image to 100, dragging it so that the boat is moved to the left corner. Making sure to set it at right place by comparing it to the original background. Next, moving to the masking screen of the lost edited double exposure filter. Here with the effect hidden, with the value of the brush set at 100, brushing roughly on the part where the boat is located. Then zooming in as much as possible, which gives a hard feather selection, and carefully brushing on the boat to get a precise selection. If you overdo it, you can set the brush value at 0 and brush out the selection. Toggle the eye icon to check if you have made the exact selection. Correct the mask if not. As you can see, we have literally cloned the boat on this image. Masking can also be used to hide text from the image. Here I'm going to try hiding the number on the boat using the lens blur filter. Applying it with default values and making sure the number is blurred. Now with masking, applying it on the number. You can also make it more whiter using curves, dragging the lower point to the top to make the whole image white. With masking, brushing on top of the number to make it white. Lowering the mask transparency to 50 to make it look better. There are a lot of ways in which you can use tax brush to give the image a different look. For example, using curves with masking to change the whole ambience of the image, change the colors of part of the image, or use double exposure to manipulate the image. I will leave the links of these edits in the description below, check them out for more ideas. Now coming to the most popular way on how the masking feature is being used, the hidden text. I'm also gonna give a nice trick on how to give it a dual color tone. First, applying the text here, changing the font to make it bigger, naming it on the country this place is located, placing it on the sky with the lower parts little on the buildings. Now going to masking, with the text effect unhidden and the brush transparency at 0, brush out the text on the buildings to give it a hidden text effect. Zooming in as much as possible to give a nice feather selection. This will take a long time, so fast forwarding it. Changing the text color to a bright yellow. To give the text a dual color effect, first I need to duplicate this text filter. Tapping on the stacks icon, view edits. Here in the three dot menu, tapping copy. This basically copies all the filters applied. There is no option to copy only the text filter. Now tapping insert, which duplicates all the filters applied. Here I am going to delete all the duplicated filters other than the large text filter. This is the original filter below and the duplicated one on top. For this text, changing the color to something close to reddish color. Going to the masking screen, you can see inverting the filter gives you an interesting effect. But toggling it back and with the brush transparency at 0, zooming out and erasing the red text around the left to reveal the yellow text below, which gives you a nice dual tone text. These are just some of the ways on how to use masking to selectively apply filters on certain parts, and the possibilities are endless. Let me know in the comments below if you have any other tips on using masking or stacks brush. Thanks for watching.